Greetings, Guardians. My name is Bife here, and I feel like I can quite happily say that I'll be saying that sentence many, many more times over the years to many, many more people. Before we get into this rather large video, there are two notes. First of all, really quickly, just note that it is unscripted. I'm sitting here in this place where I just want to give you guys a raw, unfiltered little look at things and talk about things frankly and to give you my thoughts. I don't want to go ahead and give you any kind of hard, concrete stuff. A lot of this will be speculative. The second thing is yet again another reminder to go ahead and support the guys and gals over at St. Jude. And how would you best do this? In my opinion, check out the St. Jude campaign between myself and WTF Game Nation. All month long, we're raising money for them, and it's going through Tiltify, so we touch none of it. More importantly, if you donate and watch the streams and look around for stuff, go ahead and realize that there are going to be prizes. So, yeah, awesome stuff for you guys potentially to win. If you want to check out all of that, that will be the first link in all of the description. Anyway, if you've been hiding under a rock or for whatever reason this is the first thing that you're seeing about it, to catch you up really briefly on things, Bungie just dropped what is probably the largest reveal stream ever that they've ever had. Like, literally, there are massive changes coming to Destiny, and a lot of them are really good. In fact, I'd say all of them are really good. So, let's start up at the top. First of all, the next big expansion that's coming is coming in September, and it's called Shadowkeep. It drops on September 17th, and it features us going back to the moon and returning, and I would simply say that that's cool in its own, but there's even more to it, because there are these terrible phantasmal nightmares of old beings and old bosses that we faced before and killed. Bosses like, say, Crota, bosses such as what I believe to be the original Gate Lord from back in the Destiny 1 campaign. Bosses such as Ghoul, bosses like Skolas and Tanix, all of these old enemies that are infamous that we suddenly get to revisit, and that in itself is really freaking cool. The idea on its own is nice because it's kind of a greatest hits thing, but also it looks like there could be some cool lore reason behind it. Now, in terms of big announcements, it wouldn't just be big if there was just a little kind of, you know, just announcement for an expansion, right? Like, this genuinely had to be game-changing for me to call it one of the biggest announcements ever, and it really is, because there's a whole slew of other things going on with Destiny 2 right now. For starters, Destiny 2 is completely changing its model. Nowadays, you're going to have an a la carte kind of selection for how you want to pay for content in Destiny, meaning that you will no longer be forced to buy bundled stuff together. You're no longer going to need one piece of content to own a new piece of content. It's gonna just be a case of, if you want that, go buy it. Which is good. Pro-consumer decision. Even better pro-consumer decision. The fact that this is now going to go free to play. For the most part. Let me kind of explain that. To the best of my understanding, and if I'm wrong, I'm sure the comments section will go ahead and correct me on this. To the best of my knowledge, basically what will happen is, after Shadowkeep's launch and after everything going forward, Destiny will start to switch to a free-to-play model where the only things you'll need to pay for are the latest content offerings. So if you want to own the content and play it at launch, you'll pay for that. But if you want to go ahead and own some of the old content, or if you're willing to wait, you won't have to pay. I do not know entirely if that's the case. I feel like I'm kind of muddling this one a bit, but if I'm incorrect, please let me know in the comments section. Regardless, it means that owning Destiny is going to become a whole lot cheaper. If you want to follow the train of latest releases, yeah, that's awesome. If not, you just need to go ahead and wait. Also, the biggest announcement I think out of this entire thing is that cross-save is a thing. Yeah, we had a billion leaks about that, but cross-save is indeed happening. Apparently, the PS4 guys over at Sony literally agreed to this yesterday, and it was very much up in the air. But now it appears that you'll be able to go ahead and have the same account shared across PlayStation 4, Xbox One, PC, and now also Google Stadia, which is a new platform that they're going to be introducing Destiny on, which is kind of incredible. I didn't know if we'd see any big Stadia news, but that's amazing. It's amazing. We can play it now in a Chrome tab, and so now it justifies using all the RAM. Pretty damn cool. Furthermore than just that as well, there was a whole massive Q&A segment done with the wonderful Stefan, aka Dado Does Destiny, yeah, check him out over there. He did some fantastic work in terms of being our ambassador and our representative for the community. There's a ton of really good questions that he asked, and some good answers were given. There were some key notes that were touched upon, but for the most part, I have this feeling that when all of this comes down to it, there is a new kind of feeling to Destiny. There is a really new feeling in the air, and a new vibe generally. And it's not just because this is really positive news, but also because Destiny has suddenly turned into this pro-consumer package, right? Like, sure, you'll pay for new things, but the way that they're approaching everything now, even with probably the maintenance of the Eververse store, you now actually have some kind of reason to have that, because the vast majority of the game is free to play. I like this kind of heavy content delivery, but for the most part, all the content that you can get is free. I love the way that this is going, and I love the feeling of that, because I think ultimately that delivers for us a game that will bring in more players. And honestly, there is so much more here for that entire enticing point of let's bring new players in. Destiny 2's New Light, I believe, is what it's called, is basically this bundle that will allow people to get caught up on everything, and it's basically all of the current content in Destiny for $35. You know, you get the Destiny 2 base campaign, you get all of the two expansions after that, so Curse of Osiris and Warmind, you get Forsaken, and you get the Season Pass for Forsaken, and all of that, $35, same price. Really incredible. So glad that that's the case. And you can buy that completely separately from Shadowkeep, which is awesome. And what you can do by doing that is you can jump in with the free-to-play model, and you can jump in at 750 power, which means that you won't necessarily be in this position of disadvantage. And that's amazing. That's really awesome. Like, I'm really thrilled about this. Again, I do hope I'm getting all these details correct. It's kind of just fresh off of the stream, so yeah, that's kind of awesome. Real bombshells were dropped today in the best kind of way. The other thing as well, Destiny 2 on PC is not going to be on the Epic Games Store. They're moving content providers to Steam. So if you're looking to play there, for the time being, it looks like that's going to be the port of call, which again is another pro-consumer decision as far as I'm concerned, because people are not exactly thrilled with the Epic Games Store right now. Really not too thrilled. Anyway, with all of that said, I think the big takeaways from this day are as follows. It's a bright new future for Destiny. More people are about to get into the game. The community is about to grow and expand, and I'm really excited to see where they take it from this. Shadowkeep looks like an awesome new expansion. And more importantly than any of that, this feels like a new company. This feels like a new day. We always talk about how old Bungie is gone and new Bungie has replaced them. And that used to be a very bad thing. And there are still a lot of old faces in the picture of Bungie, you know? There's a lot of people that have been around there since the old days. People that have done amazing work. But I think we can quite proudly say now that we can be proud of everyone at Bungie, you know? Not that I'm saying that we were not proud of certain individuals over others prior to this, not at all. But what I would simply say is that there is this new energy that the community is going to feel regarding the studio, because now there is something entirely different coming towards all of us in the form of a much more what feels like a united Bungie, a Bungie united under the fact that they are free from Activision, a Bungie that is united behind this shared vision of a Destiny that they want to deliver, that they are delivering, and a far stronger looking Bungie. So I hope that that was a very sort of like, I feel like that was kind of a haphazard way of saying like, good job Bungie. And I feel like I phrased that in a far worse way than I could have, but today's not my most articulate day, I suppose. So either way, cool stuff, amazing things are happening, really excited. Okay, personal thoughts on a few things and then let's talk Shadowkeep. Personal thoughts, yeah. Amazed, excited, really love everything that I saw in this stream today. Just, wow, I cannot wait to see what happens with regards to all of these updates. I can finally play on PC now. Because you know what? It has been too damn long that I've been trying to save my veteran dialogue for all of the times that it would provide me new lore insights as opposed to explaining all of the stuff that we already knew. And that's huge. I really do love that. I also love the idea that we're going to be able to take all of our gear with us, of course, because that's huge. That was something else that was keeping everything held back for me on PlayStation 4, as was PlayStation 4 exclusives, which are no longer a thing, and I'm super frickin' thrilled about that, because it means I can actually go all over the place. Seriously. That's huge. That's amazing. I really love it. I can't wait. Furthermore, let's just go ahead and let's talk lore stuff, because yeah, I'm sure a lot of you guys are actually here for that. Shadowkeep. Okay, so the idea is as follows, to give you the most brief and what I hope is accurate synopsis of things. You're sitting there and looking into the moon again, and the moon suddenly has this brand new scarlet fortress that's been raised around the Hellmouth. The entirety of the place has been changed, and Eris Morn is back. She is now representing us again. She's probably going to be the main face that we have contact with during the Shadowkeep expansion. And beyond just that, not only is Shadowkeep delivering a whole bunch of different gameplay changes, but also Shadowkeep is delivering these phantasmal enemies. Now, these enemies are literally all of the old bosses that we fought, a kind of greatest hits reel, if you will. These are going to be bosses such as Skolas and Tanix, Crota, maybe I believe I saw the original Gate Lord from the Destiny 1 vanilla campaign, you're looking at Gaul from Destiny 2, all of these old enemies that we fought before and who are infamous to us, but now have been resurrected as nightmares. And resurrected is maybe not the correct word here, because immediately that conjures back the image of something like, say, a zombie. And that's certainly not what these are. At least I don't believe they are, because for starters, they look much more, well, true to form. And secondly, because if you take a look into Hive lore, you'll notice that Nokris is outlawed for the most part, and Nokris is outlawed partly because of the fact that he has this heretical power of necromancy and the ability to bring things back from the dead. Remember that the Hive believe that death is kind of a sacred thing. They believe that when something dies, it's fulfilled its purpose as part of the sword logic, by dying allowing something else to become stronger as a result. And so they're very against this entire idea of necromancy because it derides the idea of strength. However, I think the really important thing to note here is that there must be a bigger power behind this. And I have a horrible feeling that certain Ascendant Hives who I won't mention are probably involved, although that's nothing I want to speculate on. But the interesting thing is that Eris apparently unleashed these shadows. Now, it was also raised by Datto in the stream, a question about whether Eris was evil or not, and the answer was not exactly given as wholly convincing. It was one of these kind of non-answers, so to speak, and I think that's very deliberate because Eris is one of those characters in Destiny that really epitomizes the shade of grey. Her intentions have always been good, I believe, but the way that she gets things done has involved the use of old Hive magic in some instances, some of quote-unquote Tolan's tricks, and further beyond just that, she is really just surrounded by all of the influence of the Hive, and it's really hard to trust someone like that, and I think Bungie deliberately plays on that fact a lot. So, cool. I love the way that this is going. I have no idea what the real kind of menace behind all the shadows is, because something has to have done this, and I think we'll get the context for what did this at some point later. The why these shadows have appeared question is going to be the really big kind of question. It is almost undoubtedly Hive influence, but from what? I will leave you to speculate on that and potentially create Imbaru later in the comments. Also, yeah, big thing about returning to the moon. There's a lot of specters that we could raise here, and I don't mean that in the shadow sense, I mean that in terms of old stories that have taken place. You could be looking at, say, the original colonizing Earth elements on the moon, which you can see still all over the place. You can see this in the potential echoes of the Battle of Mare Imbrium, fought between the Hive and the Guardian Army of Thousands that was defeated. And furthermore than just that, I feel as though there is a whole bunch of other stories about the new Fallen settlement that's been set up, and what that could potentially mean. Because of course, the House of Exile made its home on the moon. So, yeah, it's exciting. It's really exciting. And at current, there's a whole picturesque landscape of stuff that Bungie could be doing with this lore. It's not entirely clear what the lore behind this is, and it's all up in the air right now. So I want to go ahead and just leave that to you guys. There will be more details going forward, but I want to say on a personal note that I'm a really excited bife right now. I'm a really excited gamer. I really want to see where this goes, and I have not felt this confident about Destiny since they revealed and then I first played Forsaken and realized that I got my Destiny back, and that our game was back where it needed to be. It's taken a year, and now they're announcing the most foundational changes. Like, I want everyone to think about that. We went from Destiny 2 and its relatively botched release to, in a year, the sudden release of Destiny 2 Forsaken and some of the most ground-changing foundations of all of Destiny, to all of a sudden the announcement that it's going free to play and the announcement that all of a sudden we're going to be getting all of this stuff with cross-save and there's no more exclusives. It feels like Bungie is going to be doing all sorts of new changes to the game, and it feels like the game we're going to be getting is going to be foundationally different. The other last thing I want to say is I'm glad they're not talking about Destiny 3 yet. I'm glad that they want to build out Destiny 2 as a big first offering. And you know what? That in itself is awesome. So yeah, just really, really, really freaking happy today. I want to sit down and talk with all of you about this in the coming days, because really, there's still so much that we need to talk about, and so much that will be revealed, I'm sure, but for the time being, I want to leave it there, kind of informal outro to this, guys. Go ahead and check everything out with regards to the St. Jude stuff that we're running over at WTF with myself. It's going to be fantastic. Yeah, I can't wait. And if you want more content, go ahead and do the subscribe thing. I know all of that typical stuff. Like this video if you're so inclined. To all of the new people who are playing Destiny or who are going to be playing Destiny when it becomes free to play, welcome to this wonderful community. It's going to be amazing. Yeah. This is a great day for Destiny. I cannot wait. And as Bungie said well before me, a phrase that I have stolen, Corodacia Arastra. I'll see you, Starside.